today's episode's a little bit different. It's not like a full episode where I'm going to work and showing you what I do. Today's a tutorial, and I'm going to call it episode 29.5. I'll show you what I'm talking about. You probably clicked this video wanting to know how to cut wedges that look just like these. I'm going to show you right now how to do that. First things first, you're going to need a drop saw. You will then need a piece of timber that is at least 140 mil long, like going with the grain. When cutting wedges, you need to make sure that at least one side of across the grain is square. Shit, I was using that to get good lighting because the sun hits it and it's, yeah. So now in order to get like even wedges, nice, perfect, even wedges, you need to make sure that your piece of timber is perfectly 140 mil from your square. From your square side. Why you always hate to break bread? Think about the way that you can feel a deficit. Alright, so now we have our piece at 140 mil wide. Butt it to your backboard. We've got our saw set to 2.5 degrees. And you just want to sight down the blade until pretty much you can just see a wedge, like a formed wedge. Once you're happy with the point on the piece of timber, and you can see the wedge, then make your cut. So now after you've cut one, all you have to do is flip your piece of timber over, sight down your blade till you see the wedge, and make your cut again. And there we go. And the less degrees you use on the base plate equals the thinner this portion will be. Why you always hate to break bread? Think about the way that you will feel a deficit. Jokes on you, it's time to come
through. Well, if she had to choose me or her mom, I know I wouldn't.
This is the classic jam material for us in Australia. It's just 90 mil by 19 pine. That's what most guys I see at job sites cut their wedges out of. I like the hardwood wedges, but anyway, if you don't have hardwood, obviously use the jam material. So you mark your 140. Okay, so you will have to do something a little bit different if you are cutting it out of this type of material, and that is, if you're going to cut it like this, that's super dangerous. Well, what I've come up with. Okay, so we have our saw set to 2.5 degrees. You get your piece you're cutting the wedges out of, put it against the backboard, sight your blade to the point, and then you get your other little off cut of the same thickness, put it there, and then you get a third piece of timber like this. And you put it like that, and you just rest your hand nice and firm down more towards this side, and the pressure will stay on that piece. I'll show you what I mean. There's a wedge. Same as before, just flip it over. Sight down your point. Pressure. And there you go, perfect repeatable wedges. That is much, much, much safer than holding it like that. Don't do that. Hope this helped a few people out there. If you like these sorts of videos. I might do one like one once a week, just like a quick tip video, 3 or 4 minutes long, if I can come up with something during the week. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in some more episodes. Bye. Well, if she had to choose me